Hi everyone, it's Vicky here. Today I'm making another art journal page. So I'm starting by applying gesso on both of my pages. I'm using a spatula to do that. I'm using a spatula and not a brush because I want to add some texture on the background. I get a lot of questions about gesso. What is it for and if you need to use it? Well, it depends on what you want to do. Gesso is a primer. It adds enough texture on your background for your paints to hold on to. It protects your pages since markers and paint will not bleed through, and helps you use less paint since it doesn't soak into the paper and you can apply it easier. You don't want to use gesso if you are going to use watercoloring or spraying with dilutions, for example. You need the absorbent ability of the paper in these cases. Now, as you can see, I've finished applying gesso with my spatula on both pages. And here is the texture. Hopefully you can see that. And just because I'm too impatient to wait for it to dry, I've used my heat gun to speed up the process. On today's journal, I'm going to use gelatos in many different ways, so you can see how amazing they are and how many different techniques you can achieve by using them. I'm going to use the blues for my background, and I've chosen a lighter and a darker one. I'm just applying it all over. It's soft and creamy, and it applies very quickly and easily. And now you can do lots of things. You can dip your brush in water and just achieve a watercolor look. You can move the paint with your finger or with a baby wipe. I've decided to do the finger technique here since I want the color to be more saturated. Just because I have applied gesso on the background, I can move the paint easily. It always helps to have a baby wipe close by, so you can add a bit of moisture on your finger. And now I'm doing exactly the same thing on the other page. After applying a darker shade of blue on top of the pages, I'm now using a gel medium and I'm just going to seal everything down. Gel medium will turn my page to non-pore surface and I'll be able to use markers to do some shading later on. And here is a tip. If you want to seal down gelatos using a gel medium, don't use a wet brush. Your brush should be dry, or else the moisture on the brush will move the ink around. Just use a dry brush and dip it only on gel medium. No water, no nothing. The idea is to create a dream catcher. I'm going to use this doily mask to create the main part of my dream catcher, but also I'm going to use this cycle die, and I'm going to cut out a cycle here. I'm going to create my own mask here, and I'm going to do double stenciling or something. I don't know how to call this technique. I'm basically going to apply this, the one I've created, on top of my page, and then the doily stencil on top of that. And just because I don't want this to be too symmetrical, I'm not going to add the circle on the top corner, like having only a quarter of it, but more on the top half of the page. So I'm just securing my two stances there. And I can use modeling paste or embossing paste, and they are basically the same thing. And I'll go with the embossing paste for today. When embossing paste dries, it has a softer feeling to the touch, more like foam. And also I have the feeling that it takes a bit more time to dry than the modeling paste. And as you can see, just because I made my own stencil there, I have a nice round edge on my dream catcher. And now it's time to add some details here and there. I'm using this stencil by Simon Says Stamp, and I'm going to use my picket fence distress paint there. And just because it's very juicy, it doesn't have great results on top of a stencil, as you can see here. And that's why I decided to add the paint on top of my craft sheet and then use a finger dabber. Using the finger dabber, I'm making sure that I don't pick up too much juicy paint, and I can control how much paint I apply. And you'll see that once I remove the stencil, I did get a better result. I'll continue doing the same thing on the edges and in the center of the pages, using the same technique. And now I'm using the bottle of the distress paint and add some white paint all around the edges. After inking the edges, I'm pleased with the background, so I'll go on and create my dream catcher. These are feather dies by Simon Says Stamp, and I'm going to cut out 6 of them using my die cutting machine. The cardstock I'm using is Manila cardstock by Ranger. One of the most common questions that I get when I'm uploading my videos is where can I find this supply, or what's the name of that product? Just to remind you all that all the supplies I'm using are always listed below the video here on YouTube or on my blog. Now I'm going to use oranges and yellows to color in the feathers. As you can see, coloring is really easy to do. I'm just using I've started using the lighter color, and I'm going from orange to dark orange, and then I'll use my finger to blend everything out. You'll see blending with gelatos is very easy. I'm just rubbing between the lines there, and I use a different finger for blending the light colors and another finger for blending the darker colors. I always have a wet baby wipe close by. And now this is again Manila cardstock by Ranger, and I'm using that to cut out a ring, which will create actually the border for my dream catcher. I'm cutting down the cardstock, and now I'm going to cut out the ring. I've just placed one die circle inside of the other, and I'll run it through my cattle bag. And once the ring is ready, I'm going to use again the gelatos and color it in. If you want to know how I choose the colors that I'm using, let's just say that I like to follow rainbow colors on my pages, or follow the color wheel. If you know how color wheel works, you know that orange and blues are a perfect match. So I couldn't have done a better combination. I like how striking orange looks on top of blue. And now it's time to put everything together. So I'm using gel medium to stick everything down. First I'm sticking the edge of the dream catcher, and then I'll use my gel medium to do the same for the feathers. You'll see that once this ring is down, and before I go on and adhere the feathers on my page, I'm just using my Faber-Castell big brush markers and add some shading, as I usually do on my pages. I could go ahead and use gelatos to do this shading, and you'll see me do that technique also at the end of the video. I'm just to show you that you can use gelatos for everything, more or less. And now that I'm finished with shading, it's time to adhere the feathers on top of my page. Here I have glued down the feathers using gel medium, and now it's time to add some texture again on the background. I'm using post-it just to cover the feathers. I don't want text on top of them. And also I'm using a dark blue. I think that's cobalt archival ink, and I'm just stamping here and there. The stamp is a French text stamp that's by Impression Obsession. And again, you can find a link on the stamp and all the products just below the video. Now I'm using a fine tip black marker to draw some lines that will connect the actual dream catcher with the feathers. And again, I'm adding some shading all around the feathers using my big brush marker by Faber-Castell. To add more interest on the page, I decided to go over those black lines that connect the feathers with the dream catcher and add there some thread. So I'm using my tacky glue pen and just draw a line of glue over that black line, and I'll just stick the thread on top. And just because all dream catchers have some beads on them, I'm using those enamel dots in colors of orange, blue and yellow, and just add them here and there. I think adding those enamel dots really made them difference, and they added just the amount of detail that I needed. So I think they are the perfect finishing touch. And now it's time to add the quote. I'm using those alphabet stamps by Hero Arts, and I'm going to use a jet black archival ink to stamp the word dream. As you can see, I'm testing the stamp first, just to make sure that I haven't sticked any letter upside down. And just because I'm stamping on a surface that has lots of texture, it's difficult to have a perfect stamping. But if that bothers you, just use your markers and fill in the gaps. For the rest of the coat, I'm using this cute set of mini alpha stamps that I have since forever. And just because it might take me a while to start looking for the correct letter and then stamp it, I'm enjoying a cup of coffee, as you can see here, while stamping. To highlight my letters, I'm using the gel pen by Uniball and I'm just adding some lines here and there. And finally, I'm using Gelatos to add some shading. You can see that you can add shading with your Faber-Castell big brush markers or with the Gelatos themselves. And finally, I'm adding some white splashes here and there. One of the questions that I get a lot is how I find my inspiration. Sometimes I get inspiration from quotes and sometimes I get inspiration from older works, just like this one. This is a card I've created a couple of months ago and I decided to make it an art journal and maybe later on I'll actually do it as a canvas. Same idea in three different ways. So that's the video for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired.